It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you discover anything unexpected this week that needs to be explained? In your explorations of the life sciences in the 16th century, you encountered many different, sometimes contradictory, explanations. Interpretations have varied immensely over time and continue to be disputed even today. To see how this is so, let's consider two factors that profoundly shaped the life sciences in the 16th century. First, consider the impact of the New World upon European natural history. Imagine that you are talking with a friend in a coffee shop, and your friend says something like this: 16th century natural histories and illustrated herbals represent an explosion of knowledge about animals and plants found in non-Mediterranean regions of the world, including Northern Europe and the New World. While this increase in knowledge is important, these new discoveries did more than merely enlarge the subject matter of natural history. Rather, natural history became transformed from an emblematic endeavor to a descriptive form of botany and zoology. In the earlier emblematic approach, everything known about a plant or animal was deemed important, including an organism's allegorical symbolism, emblematic meanings, and literary allusions. The New World organisms had no such history and no traditional emblematic significance for Europeans. Therefore, naturalists were forced to limit themselves to providing only natural descriptions of these new organisms. Rather quickly, descriptions of Old World organisms followed suit, and they were stripped of their emblematic garb. Do you agree with your friend's contrast between emblematic and descriptive approaches to natural history? What examples might the two of you talk about? What more would you say in reply? Second, let's consider the impact of natural magic. Imagine that you are talking with a friend in a coffee shop, and your friend says something like this: from the Hermetic tradition of Marsilio Ficino in the 15th century, to the alchemy, astrology, and natural magic of Paracelsus and Giambattista della Porta in the 16th century, organicist and occultist perspectives on nature provided an impetus to experimental science. Magic was the search for hidden causes. For natural magic, these causes were believed to be natural, though hidden. Natural magicians employed empirical methods to discover the secrets of nature. Do you agree with your friend's assessment of the natural magic tradition? What examples might the two of you talk about? What more would you say in reply? These two factors, New World discoveries and the natural magic tradition, profoundly shaped the life sciences in the 16th century. What is the most significant implication of what you have learned this week? What is your interpretation?